Hi, today I'm going to discuss about single phase half bridge converter with RL load. In last class I've discussed single phase half bridge inverter with resistive load. There we have seen that even harmonics are not present in our system, but odd harmonics are there. We have analyzed the output voltage waveform and find out the fundamental component required for our application. Today we will see some more features of this half bridge inverter, and we will connect across the RL load. We will observe the behavior of the switches when the load is inductive. So let's start. This circuit, last class I have explained that when the switch 1 is on, current will flow in this direction and output voltage will be VDC1. And when switch 2 is on, at that time switch 1 is off, then current will flow in opposite direction and the voltage is VDC1. So as the current is opposite, so the output voltage will get opposite to previous one. So both positive and negative half cycle output voltage will get. Now let's see what is the voltage across the switch when the switch is off. So let's consider that switch number 1 is on and 2 is off. Then we want to find the voltage across this switch 2. Let's see. So when switch 1 is on, current will flow in this direction. So the voltage across this resistance is equal to VDC1. Now polarity of this voltage is positive negative. Here also across VDC1 you can see positive negative. So this VDC1 and this voltage across the resistance, that is also VDC1, added up and will appear across this switch 2. So this voltage equal to twice of VDC1. So this is one of the demerit of this single phase half bridge inverter, that voltage across the switch is too much high. So larger size or high rating switches we have to select for single phase half bridge inverter. This property I will compare with single phase full bridge inverter when I will explain this single phase full bridge inverter. So for the time being, let's connect RL load across the single phase half bridge inverter. See, so here the circuit is same, only this load is changed. Now it is RL load. When the switch is on, current will flow in this direction. When switch 1 is off, then opposite current will. Let's see the equivalent circuit. Here, when switch 1 is on, the voltage across this RL load is equal to positive negative, or positive voltage we are getting. And when switch 1 is off and 2 is on, then opposite direction current will flow and voltage will get. Here it will be positive and negative, you can see here. So here switch 2 is on. So positive, negative. Now across the inductor, we know that suppose when switch 1 is on, then current will flow in this direction and inductor will get charge. Now the property of inductor is that it will not allow the change in current instantaneously. So at the time when switch 2 is made on, so the current will not reverse as soon as switch 2 is made on. So the stored energy across the inductor will try to find a path through which it can discharge its current. At the same time, voltage across the diode D1 and D2, we will observe that it is positive or negative. If it is negative, then obviously it will be reverse bias, but if it is positive, then the diode will, get forward bias. So the least impedance path inductor will choose to discharge its energy. So today I will discuss this topic. Let's see. So in the output voltage waveform, here this is positive output voltage. and this one negative output voltage. So we can see, though the load is changed from resistive to RL load, the output voltage waveform remains same. So that's why the inverter is known as voltage source inverter. Here the output voltage remains constant, it is independent of load. Now let's see the voltage across the inductor. So this is our inductor voltage, and this is current through the load, and these are the switching pulses across switch number 1, and this is for switch number 2. You can see when switch number 1 is on, still the current is negative. Again come back to the circuit. When switch number 1 is on, what I am saying, the current will flow in this direction. So current is positive and the output voltage is positive. But there we are seeing that this current is still negative. What is the reason behind it? Let's see. Start from this point. So here the switch 2 is made on. At that time, what is the voltage across the inductor? Observe here, the voltage across the inductor when the switch 2 is made on, it is minus 200 volt. That is more than the VDC. VDC 1 is 100 volt. So this inductor voltage is negative. Switch 2 is on. Let's see again the circuit. Yeah. Inductor voltage is negative, indicates here it will be negative and here it is positive. Then this voltage is 200 volt, negative positive, and this voltage is 100 volt. So what is the net voltage difference ignoring this voltage across the resistance? So this 200 minus of 100, that means 100 volt, and that 100 volt will be with positive, negative and positive. So this voltage will come across this diode number 2, and this negative will come across cathode. So there is favorable condition for this diode number 2, and the current will continue to flow in the same direction. Again see the waveform here. Before this point, before switch 2 is on, 1 was on. 1 was on means current was flowing in this direction. Now we are making the switch 2 on. Then instantly the current will not change its direction, or it will not allow to change the current. So current will choose the path through which it can flow. So the alternative path for the current is through this diode D2, and the current will continue to flow till VL is equal to this 100 volt. Then potential across this one, you can say it will be 0. Then the diode D2 will be turned off, and already pulses are there across the switch number 2. Now current can flow in this direction. So the current will now flow in this direction. So before flowing through switch number 2, current will continue to flow through diode number 2 till inductor voltage is more than the this DC source voltage. Then switch 2 is on, then current will flow in this direction. So the current will become opposite to the previous one. Let's see. Here D2 is on, so current continue to flow. So here it is positive current, but just after this line you can see the current is coming negative. So current is coming negative, that means current is flowing now in this direction. It is opposite to the reference one. So it is through the switch number 2. So switch number 2 is now on, D2 is off. and the current is opposite and the voltage is negative. Let's see. So during this period the switch 2 is on. Here also when D2 is on, voltage will be negative, or switch 2 is on, voltage will be negative. So there is no effect on the output voltage. It will continue and it will remain same because of the diode. So during this period D2 will be on, then switch 2 will be on. Now at this point switch 1 is made on and the switch 2 is off. As soon as switch 2 is off, what is the voltage across the inductor? Let's see. So here the voltage across the inductor, you can see here it is close to 200 volt and its polarity is now opposite to the reference one just now we have discussed. So it is positive. So let's see that. Now when the switch 2 is made on, voltage across the inductor, here it is positive, here it is negative, and it is 200 volt. So positive, negative, and here it is 100 volt. What is the net voltage across this one? So this is positive, negative, negative, positive. So this voltage minus this voltage, that means 100 volt. So 100 volt is there, and that is sufficient to drive this diode D1, and current will continue to flow in the same direction. So what, when switch 2 was on, the direction of current was this one, and when switch 1 is made on, 2 is off, then current will continue to flow in the same direction, but not through the switch but through the diode, till the voltage across the inductor is equal to voltage across the source, that means 100 volt 100 volt, then this diode will be reverse bias, or you can say driving voltage is not there for this diode number 1. Then switch number 1, switch impulses are available, so the current will continue in this direction. So before achieving this current, current will flow through D1. After that the current will reverse. Let's see the way. See, at this instant this inductor voltage is more than the source voltage, so diode D1 will be forward biased and current is now, it is up to this point, you can see the current is negative. So this is your reference line and the current is negative, so negative current is flowing. After that the current is positive, and the positive current you are getting because the switch 1 is now on, so this positive current you will get. After that again the same cycle will continue and you will see this one. So you can see that either switch 1 is on or D1 is on, voltage will remain same, because you know voltage across the switch or voltage across the diode when it is conducting is ideally 0. So output voltage is not affected by the type of load. That's why this kind of converters are known as voltage source inverter. Let's see the instantaneous load current. Last class we have found out this instantaneous output voltage. Now the current, we know that in case of inductive load, current will lag the supply voltage. So that's why the term here, it is sine n omega t minus theta. Theta n is the lagging angle. And this current is equal to voltage divided by the impedance. So it is square root of r square plus n omega l square, where n is equal to 1, 3, 5 or any odd number. And theta n is equal to 10 inverse n omega l by r. And the fundamental output power is equal to fundamental RMS output voltage, fundamental RMS output current into cos of theta 1. So this is your fundamental output power, and it is the useful power we want from the inverter. And the harmonic output power, or you can say or third harmonic, fifth harmonic, or other harmonic power, that is V03, I03, cos theta 3, or V05, I05, cos theta 5. So those powers are not useful, those are dissipated across the load. So our aim is to reduce those harmonics. You can observe in case of motor load, if these harmonics are fed, then if the magnitude of third harmonic, fifth harmonic are more, then too much heat is developed across the winding. That's why for motor operation, purely sinusoidal waveforms are generally preferred. So today I have discussed about single phase half bridge inverter with RL load and very interesting characteristics of switch. Here we have seen that because of diode, the inductor gets a path to discharge its energy and the output voltage remains unaffected. That's why this kind of converters are known as voltage source converters, where the output voltage waveform is independent of load impedance. Then we have found out the fundamental RMS current and fundamental output power. In next class, I will discuss single phase full bridge inverter. Thank you.